I wanted to wish the best person that I've ever known in my life a very happy birthday today. Krista Marie Garrett, you're 44 years old today. Congratulations. I met you when you were 23, and it's hard to believe that you're 44. This is always a fun time of the year for me because it shows that you're 4 years ahead of me. You're 44 and I'm 40. So I always get to enjoy this for the 50-day period before it's my birthday. But I just wanted to personally tell you, if you didn't already know, that you are the kindest, sweetest person I've ever known in my life. I'm so happy that you're my wife, that you chose to spend the rest of your life with me. You're an amazing mother. You're an amazing friend. Even though you do still care way too much what other people think, that's probably your biggest downfall. But that's not a bad thing. I could think of worse things to have, character traits to have. You're the moral compass of me. You always do the right thing. You always try to do the right thing. And you know, watching you over the past 21 years as a person, the way you've grown, it's amazing. I mean, you were a great person when I met you, but today you are truly, truly special. I don't like being without you. I don't like being away from you. I feel whole when I'm around you. I hope you have an awesome birthday, and I love you with all my heart. So I'm sorry you have to work today on your birthday. I think a funeral tonight at the church. I will be taking you out Tuesday night for your birthday. So you'll be 44 years old plus one day that we'll do the real celebration. It's also been a lot of fun over the years. You know, one thing I gotta talk about is, why'd you have to be born on April 11th? I mean, your birthday falls on the Masters every single year. And that's been a lot of hardship for me. I mean, of course, I always still watch the Masters, but, you know, it was kind of a bummer in those early years because you didn't quite understand. That's really a Brad problem, not a Krista problem. I thank you for putting up with me, for putting up with not being, well, you know, kind of being a slob. I know in the early years you try to change that, but I think you realize that that's just who I am. And you accepted me for who I am, and I appreciate that too. Max had a few words he wanted me to tell you as well. Max also thinks you're the most amazing person he's ever met. He says he loves you more than me, which is debatable, and I don't even know how he could prove it. He says that you're all he ever thinks about. He says he dreams about you. He says you're on his mind 24 hours a day. So, I mean, you know, he's a dog. I don't know how we can prove this. But he says he loves you more than me. So I sometimes think he's trying to kill me. The other day I woke up doused in gasoline, and Max had a box of matches. You know, I mean, he's actually scary. But, you know, I just want to keep peace. He said that if I didn't say the words that he spoke to me to put on this film, that he would kill me. So it's in the film. It's been documented. Our girls adore you. I know you're hard on them, but I'd rather you be hard on them than let them do whatever they want to do. I think you're doing a phenomenal job. Anytime you second guess yourself, just remember that, you know, you've done a great job. They're going to be great adults. I'm very proud of the humans they're turning out to be. They're very respectful, they're kind, they're caring, and you've done a great job teaching them. I love you, you're beautiful, and let's talk about this. I mean, you were hot when I met you, but man, you are like smoking hot now. I apologize for hitting on you 24/7. I can't help myself. I think I'll be like that until I die. When we're 85 years old, I'm gonna be hitting on you. So it's just something you're gonna have to deal with. I think you realize that now. And again, I want to apologize that first year of marriage when you told me with that delicious red, that big gigantic box of delicious red wine that we had in our first one-bedroom apartment off of Walnut Street in Dallas, the hood. You told me not to put my wine glass where we were putting the mattress, and I didn't listen. I knocked the glass over. Delicious red everywhere. And what about the time that we had those Mormon friends that we went out to dinner with, and we told them about the story where we got in a heated argument, and I threw a fork at you, and it stuck in your side for a second. We never did hear from those Mormons again, did we? the great times. Or what about the time before we were married when I was being a total jerk, and I think we're at my parents' house, and I had a Bloody Mary in my hand, and you sucker punched me, and my Bloody Mary went all over the wall? Good times. Well, we haven't had the need to be violent or throw forks in over 20 years, and that's been fun. It's nice that I'm just glad that we accept each other for who we are, and we enjoy each other's time with each other. And I'm just so proud of you. I'm so proud that you're my wife, and I feel very blessed that you chose me to let me be your husband and build a life with you. I love you. Happy birthday. Bye-bye.